Hi everybody, my name is Dr. Lindsay Fisher. I'm a physical therapist from Total Performance Physical Therapy. I am here today to talk to you about three exercises for tennis elbow. This is also known as lateral epicondylitis, and it's an inflammation of your forearm muscles. We often will feel it either right in this muscle of your forearm, in the outside of your elbow, or into your hand. Sometimes you may feel it as well on your wrist. It is an overuse and repetitive injury to your arm, and it often comes from either those repetitive motions, using your mouse too much, sometimes hammering and housework, and we'll get into a couple more later. Oftentimes you'll feel pain with grabbing a cup or a mug, we often hear that a lot, or you'll get pain with shaking someone's hand, turning a key, turning a doorknob, and all those motions. The cause of this is often, like as I was saying before, it's an overuse injury to the muscle of the forearm. Repeated muscles or repeated motions in your daily activities, and sometimes it can come from playing tennis. Doesn't always have to come from playing tennis, even though it is known as tennis elbow. Sometimes even cutting meats, cutting vegetables throughout the day, cooking different things with the arm, just those repetitive motions can cause this. You'll actually get little micro tears in your muscle of your forearm or up in the tendon in the elbow. So ways to treat this, and I'm going to go over three exercises to perform. But first and foremost, you need to remove whatever activity in your daily life is causing that injury. You actually need to take that out for, you know, a week or two until things can calm down and you start to feel a little bit better. You may even need to take it out a little bit longer, but if you keep doing those motions over and over throughout the day, no matter how much you're treating it, you probably will not reach, feeling better completely. So you need to remove that, whether it's playing tennis, maybe step back for a week or two. If you need to remove cutting things, if you need to remove using that mouse, and if it's things that you can't take out of your daily activities, that's when you need to go see a physical therapist, find out ways that you can alter the movements that you're doing so you're decreasing the inflammation in that area. Okay, so the exercises to start, first is a stretch. You're going to stretch this forearm, and what you're gonna do is make sure you have a straight elbow. If you don't have a straight elbow during the stretch and you push down, you're not gonna get the benefits of the stretch. You're not even gonna feel the stretch. So straight elbow, hand pointed down, and your other hand you're actually gonna take and push into that stretch. You're gonna feel a nice stretch along the muscle belly of the forearm. You may feel it into the elbow. You're gonna hold this stretch for about 30 seconds, okay? And you're gonna do this stretch at least 4 times, all right? And I would recommend actually doing the other side as well, because, you know, if this arm is hurting, you may start to compensate and use this side more. You don't want it to occur on this side by using this one too much. And it's always a good idea to do both sides, okay? So nice 30 second stretch, okay? And then come out of it and go back again, and once again, straight elbow, wrist bent down. Okay, so that's the first one. This you can do multiple times a day. I would say once in the morning, once in the evening. If you're doing a lot of those repetitive motions throughout the day, you might want to stretch it a little bit more. So after you get done doing something, then go ahead and do a setup then, okay? The exercise number two, it's a strengthening exercise, and it's gonna be rotating that arm over and back down. Now with this, you wanna make sure the forearm and elbow is nice and supported. You don't wanna hold it out here because you can cause some other issues at the shoulder and upper arm, and we don't wanna create that. So, palm facing down, okay? And you're just going up and back over, rotating that arm, okay? This will probably be too easy. Now, if you feel pain while doing this, don't add a weight yet, okay? We need to start slow. Okay, and you're gonna do 30 of these. If you need to break it up into sets of 10, that's fine, okay? If it gets a little bit too easy, you can add a weight, and you're actually gonna grab the end of the dumbbell with your palm facing down. You're gonna slowly rotate up, and then slowly rotate back down. If you start to get pain when you reach about here, okay, or anywhere in the rotation, stop. Don't push through it. If you push through it right now, it's already inflamed enough, and you don't wanna inflame it anymore. Okay, so if that means for today you're doing the 30 reps and you have to stop here, that's fine, and then come back. Maybe, hopefully tomorrow, you'll be able to maybe go a little bit further before you feel that pain, okay? And that kind of can tell you that you're getting a little bit stronger as you do it, okay? So that is the second exercise. That's known as supination and pronation. The third exercise is going to be a wrist extension. Okay, so if I turn to the side here, it's pulling that wrist up. So once again, maybe start without a weight if it's really inflamed, okay? And you can bring it up and back down, nice and slow. Don't do these too quickly, okay? Nice and slow, up and back down. Now, if you can tolerate this, you can add a weight. And when I say add weight for all these exercises, start with something small. You'd be surprised how much 1 pound, this is actually a 2 pound weight, how much weight this can be in your arm. So you're gonna come all the way down, come up and back down. Okay, it's not a very big movement. And you may feel the pull in the forearm. If it's painful, you can stop, okay? If you're just feeling that muscle burn, that muscle work a little bit, that's fine. You're actually strengthening that muscle, okay? And you're gonna do 30 repetitions of this. You can stop at 10, take a rest, 10 more, take a rest, and your final 10. So those are the three stretches, okay, or the three exercises, the stretch, the supination and pronation with that forearm supported, and then the wrist extension. In order to do these exercises, you also need to make sure that it's not too inflamed. So that's when you wanna ice, okay, take down the inflammation. After you get done doing these exercises, you can ice. Maybe before, start with some heat or warm up the arm a little bit so that you're ready to go and those muscles are ready to work. Those are the three exercises for tennis elbow. If you are experiencing pain and you've had pain for 2 weeks, please come in, please give us a call, come in and see us and we can help you take care of that pain or change your daily activities so that you're not gonna continuously do those repetitive motions and cause your tennis elbow. Thank you very much and I will see you later.